People make mistakes. Sometimes life is just... Whoa, Burroughs! What the hell were you thinking?
What were you thinking?
I wasn't thinking.
Well, I wasn't thinking either.
Well, what was he thinking? Oh. Nah, we know what he was thinking.
It's not his...
It is always his fault. Of course it is.
I'm gonna come clean right off the bat. I'm absolutely terrified to be in this room. Because I love movies and they're my life, and you are a legend, and I've admired you, your work for so long. I'm so worried that you're not gonna like me.
Get over that.
Well, it's just you know what I mean? We see so many blunt characters that you play, and I'm afraid that you're gonna go, he's an idiot. Give me somebody else to talk to. You know?
Well, if you're an idiot, I might. Oh, but I don't think you'll be an idiot. You have to have some confidence.
Well, I do, but you just reach a certain level where it's just I've never spoken to you before. I've always, like I told you, I thought that In Her Shoes was just a phenomenal movie and so forth. So mm-hmm. you get these expectations when you go into a room, and you're so worried that you're going to be disappointed. I don't know with you. I mean, you've been in so many films and with so many directors. Can anybody teach you anything? I mean, have you learned at all? Or?
I'm learning from you right now.
What?
I'm learning that the problems you have with being intimidated are not my problem.
Okay.
That's a lesson.
Really? Well, I mean, you've done so many things in the past. I mean, do they have, people have expectations of you? Do you find that people like me that when you meet them?
You mean in real life?
Yes.
Yeah, but when you're really involved with why you like a person or admire a person or something over the years, that supersedes what you feel they might think about you. And, I'm friendly. You could meet some others that you have. Let's see, who would I? I mean, to come into the presence of Bette Davis was intimidating. I think possibly, well, there's several others, but that is of the old school. But nowadays, we're more friendly, regardless of what our credits are or what our resume says. That can be intimidating to people. But what I learn is the insides of everybody who is honest enough, like you are, to talk about it.
Yeah. When I interviewed Michael Caine for Batman, he just went on and on about, which actually added to the level of I'm scared, how he just said wonderful things about you.
He's a dreamboat, too.
Yeah, is there anybody left that you want to work with?
Yeah, that's a good question. I've got to look at, some lists, because I'm not good at remembering who is so good that I want to be part of their life. I'm just so fortunate to be working with, let's say, Nicole Kidman and Cameron and Toni Collette and Jennifer Aniston. These are the top young actresses of today that I find extraordinary. And of course, I loved working with Meryl for the same reason.
Now, you had three movies out this year, but we haven't seen a lot of you on the screen. Why haven't we seen a lot of you?
I don't know. I can't figure that out. Some of the scripts that I got were just awful. I do have some problems with what Hollywood is making. Mostly they're being directed by marketing. So whoever the marketing department thinks is the target audience, they talk. Who is the target audience? Well, who was the target audience for March of the Penguins? Who's the target audience for Crash? Who's the target audience, Munich? This whole business of having your vision. And this is the vision of authenticity that you want to tell, like the old timers used to have, and the ones that are around today, like Stephen and Rob. The visions that they have to put on the screen become authentic, and therefore the target audience is damn near everybody. They've got to feel authenticity on the screen. Clint has it. He knows what he wants to make. And out of that vision comes profit. But if you let marketing, like they did on Million Dollar Baby, they didn't want to make that. And so you just have to prevail with your vision.
Thank you for not throwing me out of the room.